Hey, this is David with Vera's Fitness. I'm a certified fitness trainer. And on this episode of Vera's Fitness, I'm going to show you the truth about abs and how you can actually get abs and how it has to do with fat loss. A lot of people, they really don't put those together. They don't put fat loss and abs together, but they totally go together. And today I'm going to show you how the real way to get abs and it's not working out your abs. So if you're thinking that you have to work out your abs to get abs, you have to watch this episode. I'll see you next. Hey, this is David with Vera's Fitness. I'm a certified fitness trainer, and today I'm going to teach you the secret about abs and how to get abs and what's the best way to get abs. By the end of this video, you should know exactly what you need to change about your life or your workout plan to get abs. So congratulations, you're on the way to getting abs. This is the secret right here. This is the best video on YouTube on how to get abs, and I'm delivering, right? I promise you that. All right, so the first thing we're going to cover is why working out your abs directly is not the best way to get abs and probably the worst way to get abs. Now, this is the big problem with working out your abs. When you work out your abs, all you're doing is you're making your ab muscles stronger, maybe a little bit bigger. So what you're doing is that you have this fat on top of your abs and you're working out your abs. So you're pushing it, you're making your abs bigger and making them stronger. So they're pushing out more. So what you might be doing actually is pushing out that belly fat out there. What you need to get rid of is you need to get rid of that belly fat. Now, how do you get rid of that belly fat? Well, before I say that, that's what I wanted to mention about earlier. When it comes to fat loss and getting abs, it's almost the same exact thing. Some people think that you, because you're losing fat, you're somebody that's really heavy or you're overweight, and that could be true. But you're in the same category as somebody who wants abs. Don't think that you're in two separate worlds, okay? If you're trying to lose weight and you're trying to get abs, same thing, right? It doesn't matter what you're trying to do. It's the same things that you have to do to get to that same goal. So don't think it's different. When it comes to getting abs and losing belly fat, you need to avoid any type of ab work or direct ab work because it doesn't really burn too many calories. And I'm going to prove that to you in a second. So here's the thing with working out your abs. You might get it bigger, you might get it stronger, but let's say a day or two goes by after your ab workout, the only fat that you're burning is like that area, which is a very small percentage of your body compared to what I'm gonna teach you right now. It's a very small percentage. You might think you're burning some belly fat, and you might be, but it's very, very low, very, very minimal. But the best workouts to do to get abs are total body workouts. And why is that? Why is it that working out your arms have anything to do with burning the fat off your stomach? Well, this is what I'm gonna teach you right now. When you're doing total body workouts, your whole body metabolism picks up. So let's say you work out your arms one day and your back and your chest and your legs, like a total body workout, like I said earlier. Now your whole body is burning calories versus just your stomach. So if you didn't know this, after a workout, your body continues to burn fat. If it's a resistance training workout, meaning you do push-ups, pull-ups, you lift weights, you do some actual like heavy weightlifting or resistance training, your body burns fat up to 48 hours after the workout. So let's say you do work out your abs, you're only burning fat from this small area for 48 hours. If you're doing total body workout, you're burning fat throughout your whole body for 48 hours. You will eventually start burning the belly fat, okay? It's very genetic as well. So if you're a person that you just recently gained a lot of weight on your arms, the first place you're going to lose fat is your arms and then the rest of the body. So that's another thing to pay attention to as well. Remember that doing total body workouts gets your whole body running instead of just your abs. All right, so the next thing is, well, I just said that already. The best way to work out your abs versus doing direct ab work is total body workouts. If you need a total body workout, I have three of them included, or maybe even more. I have some bonus workouts included in my program. It's called Fat Loss Made Simple. So I even have bonus workouts for you in there. But shameless plug, you already know, if you want to lose fat, guaranteed with me, Fat Loss Made Simple. All right, so the next thing you want to look out for is diet. Most people, if not all personal trainers and gym owners and whatnot, will tell you that abs are made in the kitchen, and it's very, very true. But I do have some blame on the workouts, because if your workouts suck, it's going to be really hard to get abs. I already taught you what's the best workout to get abs. Now I'm going to teach you what's the best diet to get abs. And it's no miracle diet. And I hate the word diet, because when you say diet, that means you're going to go on this diet, you're going to eat this way for a little bit, and then you're going to switch back to something else or whatever you're eating now. All right? Do not go on a diet. I need you to change your diet. So if you change your diet and adopt to it, you'll have abs the rest of your life. You'll be the 80-year-old dude down the street that has abs, okay? If you just pay attention to what I'm about to teach you right now. So when it comes to diet, your diet, most people will say it has to be high protein, low carbs. I'm going to have to say no to that. That is a bad, bad way to look at diets, because there are some people that do not, wouldn't function on a high protein, low carb diet. So the better way to say it is a high protein. I think everybody should get a good amount of protein in their diet every day. It doesn't matter where you get it from. But you should always have a good amount of carbs as well. And that's depending on your activity level. So if you're a person that you spend most of your day sitting down, then yes, go with a high protein, low carb diet. But if you're a person who is very, very active, you play sports, you have kids running around the house, and you're always chasing after them, you're doing housework, you're a person that works hard, you do factory work, something like that, then it's okay for you to eat more carbs than somebody who doesn't. Now, if you want the exact number of carbs, I would start off with a high protein, low carb diet. And if you're seeing that you're getting really, really tired, you're losing too much weight, you're not seeing results with your workout program, your muscles aren't growing, your body isn't getting stronger, you're very weak with every workout, then yes, add more carbs to it, okay? It's always better to go lower on the carbs and then add to it than add and then take away carbs. So start low and move on up. You should know within a week that how much carbs you should be eating. So if it's 2 or 3 days into your diet or your new diet, and you're not eating enough carbs, and you should feel really tired, you can't even think straight, add more carbs. And that's it. Those are the only two things you need to know to get abs, and that's the only true way to get abs. Forget all those people that look up on YouTube ab workouts. I'm looking for an ab workout. I'll have an ab workout, but to be honest, it's not the secret to getting abs. That's just extra, okay? Once you have your abs already, and you want to work out your abs, you want to get them a little bit more tone, this and that, then you can start doing things like that. But the main focus, especially in the beginning, for anybody who wants to get abs, if you don't have abs already, is full body workouts and getting a high protein and carbs and for your lifestyle, okay? Those are the only couple things you have to pay attention to, and that's it. So if you want more from me and you want my complete system and you want me to figure everything out for you where you don't have to question these things anymore, I have this plan that's guaranteed to work for anybody. It's called Fat Loss Made Simple. And if you stick onto the things I teach you, it's gonna work, okay? In the program, I include full body workouts, like the ones that I mentioned in this video, for you to get abs. And then on top of that, I have my diet plan. It's my step-by-step diet plan, so you don't get overwhelmed. You're just like, you're not like, oh my God, I have to really eat healthy today. I have to go buy these healthy stuff, blah, blah, blah. That really messes up everybody. So what I did is I made my diet plan made simple. It's included in the program, and it's my step-by-step. So it's 1 week you focus on this one thing, on the next week you focus on something else, but in the other 30 days you're definitely seeing results, you're on the way, you've lost some weight, and you're ready to keep it going, because fitness is not a 30-day thing. I know my program is 30 days, but it's not something that you do for 30 days and that's it. You never have to worry about it again. It's something you do for the rest of your life, and I'm going to give you the first couple steps with my program. So I hope you learned whatever I was going to teach today, the truth about abs. When you're ready to go, I'm ready for you for Fat Loss Made Simple. I'll see you on the next video, and thank you for your time. For any questions, any comments, any concerns, please leave a comment. I love those. And if you found this video helpful, please share it wherever you can. I love being shared. It lets me know that I'm doing an awesome job. And anyway, see you next time.